Hey, what is going on, everybody? So today it's time to react to Evanescence Good Enough. I said I would react to this, and now it's time to react to some more Evanescence. So a little bit about the song. The song was written by lead vocalist Amy Lee and produced by Dave Fortman. According to Amy Lee, it was written for her longtime friend and husband, Josh Hartzler. It was placed as the last track on the album, The Open Door, to symbolise a new beginning in Amy's life. So yeah, I'm super excited for this. I haven't reacted to Evanescence in a while, so yeah, let's just get straight into it. I'm really excited. And if you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe. And if you want to follow me on Instagram, then it is at George Swinson, all lowercase, no spaces, at GEORGESWINSON. And yeah, feel free to drop me a message if you want, and I will make sure I respond. But yeah, thank you so much for the support so far. I can't thank you guys enough. It's been unreal. And yeah, don't worry, there's more reactions to come soon. But yeah, I thought I'd hop back into Evanescence today. So yeah, let's just get straight into this one. I'm excited. Okay, so already I get the vibe it's going to be a slow song. I feel like, what was I going to say? This was it. She doesn't feel like she's good enough for some person, or like that person is making them feel like they're not good enough for anybody else. Something like that. But let's find out. Such a good voice. Wow. Wow. Shouldn't let you torture me so sweetly. Now I can't let go of this dream. I can't breathe, but I feel good. What a great voice. See, this is, so far, I don't know if I'm right about the message yet, but like just the vocals and stuff, you know, that this song gives me proper like theatre vibes. Like it would be a song like a musical, like a theatre. It really gives me that kind of vibe. And I think, you know, it could be sung amazingly live, like at a theatre or in a musical somewhere. It really does give me that vibe. Let me know if it has been, because it does really give me that vibe. I feel good enough for you. I don't quite get the statue thing. Wow. What a voice. Damn, that is insane. What a voice. I feel like now when she's like doing the screams and I can't say no to you and all this, obviously there's the fire spreading and everything's melting. Is that just like symbolizing the fact that she can't say no to this person who's treating her bad? I don't know if I'm getting the message right, but what I'm gathering is she can't say no to someone who's treating her bad. And basically it's just setting her life on fire. It's, I don't know, messing her, like just destroying her life. This person's destroying her life. Is this right? I don't know. But the voice is unreal. Again, it's like, I don't know. It's just like, just so raw and so real. It's insane. It's insane. Shouldn't let you conquer me completely. Now I can't let go of this dream. Can't believe that I feel good enough. I feel good. I'm confused because she then says, I can't let go of this dream, or something about surprise that she feels good enough. So is it saying that someone else treated her bad? And because obviously from what we read, it's to show like it's basically for her husband. So is it like saying that somebody else mistreated her and now she's in this really good relationship? But then I don't understand why that would mean there's fire around her and destruction happening around her. Or I don't know. Or maybe it's like, even though there's destruction around, still someone can make you feel good and all that destruction doesn't matter because you've got someone by your side. I don't know, man. I'm speculating. But yeah, let me know because I should have... that the genius description didn't give me enough information. Yeah. Such a long time coming, but I feel good. And I'm still waiting for the rain to fall. Jeez. That voice is crazy, man. That voice. Insane. To anything this good now. That's unbelievable, man. Just whatever you say, her voice is unreal, absolutely crazy, and you can really feel the emotion in it, and it's so so moving and so powerful. I can imagine, like many people have said in the comments, it really does. It really can help you through bad times, like just numb the pain or make you forget about it or just relate to it, relate to that emotion. I don't really get the what's growing as well. I've definitely missed some stuff in this one. Maybe maybe them the flowers just grew at the end. Maybe it's like, now this is, I don't know, a new life now. Starting a new life after all the destruction before her in the past. Maybe. Let me know if I'm right about that or if I'm wrong. So yeah, some of the message I missed, but lyrics and the mood, just the power in the voice is unreal. So good. Amazing. I know now why you want me to react to this. Another powerful song, another banger, another one that can definitely help people through the tough times. Yeah, really good. That was Evanescence Good Enough. Let me know in the comments what you want me to react to next. I hope you did enjoy this reaction, even though I've definitely missed some stuff. Please fill me in on that in the comments, and I'll make sure next time, if the genius doesn't give me enough information, I'll find some more information out. Other than that, thank you for watching. Please make sure you like and subscribe. And yeah, if you again, if you want to follow me on Instagram, do that too. At George Swinson, GeorgeSwinson. No spaces, it's in the description if you can't remember that. So check that out. Other than that, hopefully you like this Evanescence reaction. There'll be some more Ginger, some Tim Howard in the next couple days. But yeah, I will make sure I react to more Evanescence very soon, because I really enjoy reacting to them. Like, Amy Lee's voice is just insane. So yeah, other than that, thank you for watching, and you know, I will catch you hopefully tomorrow for another reaction video. Goodbye.